This is going to be a quick video on how to use the internal node controller on the Kenwood TS2000. When I first got the 2000 and looked into using the TNC, all I heard was that it's crippled, it's unreliable, and I can't get it to work. Well, I did some testing with one of my local friends here and found out that it is reliable and it works if it's set up with the proper configuration. There's one limitation, but if you work within that limitation, you'll love the radio. So what's the limitation? Basically, you can't send huge messages or attachments. Your text messages need to be about 30K or less, and your attachments need to be 20K or less. These are just rough numbers, but I know those numbers will work. You might want to let me know what your experiences are when you use it. If your content's larger than this, what will happen is the session may lock up on you. By and far, the large majority of all your daily and MCOM communications will be way below these numbers. And that's the limitation. It's really not too bad at all. When watching this video, I'm going to assume that you've watched my TS2000 training series and that you can control and use the hub sub radio and that you can use the main and sub menus in the radio. I'm also going to assume that you've watched my WinLink video training series, that you know how to set up and run a packet session, and you know what proper power and antenna settings to use. And thirdly, you have a working serial cable connected from your PC to the TS2000. The first thing I want to review real quickly are the settings for the radio. Of course, there's an A menu and a B menu, and I recommend you put these on the B menu. But here are the basic settings, and we've gone over this in my other videos. But the main thing I want you to notice is that menu number 46 is set for the sub radio. I prefer to use the internal TNC on the sub radio. That way I can leave it set up on the packet frequency that I normally use, and all I have to do is turn the radio on and off, and it's ready to go. So you can run it either on the sub radio or the main radio. Either one is fine, but I prefer the sub radio myself. The other item that's different is item number 55. Normally we leave packet operation off. When you're going to use the internal TNC, you want to turn the packet operation on. Let's now take a look at the settings in RMS Express to make a packet session successful. So we have packet WL2K. Let's open a session. And you can see that it's set up to initiate the Kenwood TS2000 on COM port 3 at 9600. Well, let's go look at those settings. Click on Setup. And here's the setup window. So what you'll need to do is choose the Kenwood TS2000 as the packet TNC type. Come down to the COM port and choose the one that's available. Whatever's available that you have connected should show up here. In my case, it's COM 3. You're going to set the serial baud to 9600, and that's what's set in the radio on the Kenwood TS2000 for communications. Then we're going to come down and look at the 1200 baud listing. The secret in making the internal TNC work is the maximum frame setting. Normally, when this comes out of the box, 4 is what will be in there. And what you need to do is go in and change it to 2 frames as the maximum frames. For some reason, the internal TNC doesn't do well with anything higher than 2. So set that for 2, leave everything else the same, and choose Update. The system should reinitialize, and it should come up and say ready. If it says ready, you're golden and ready to go. When you turn the sub radio on, this is the indicator that you'll get. The thing to notice here is that the TNC is indicated. It doesn't mean it's on, it's just showing you that it's on the sub radio. So we'll push the sub button and bring control, push the talk and control over so we can control this. I have 145.050 in. I also have that set up as a memory, so we can run it off the memory or just run it off the straight VFO. The other indicators that you want to see, we're going to hit the menu button.
We're on number 55, and we're going to turn that on. That's the packet operation. It's the packet TNC unit on. So now you'll see that we have a packet indicator on the screen here. The one other thing that we want to see when we open a session is we want to see the PC indicator here. That's telling us that the serial connection to the unit is good. So this is a typical look. This is the way it should look for you when you run a packet unit. So I'm going to go ahead and hit start. Make sure the squelch is set correctly, and the volume can be at any level. It doesn't really matter. I've got it turned up so you can hear it.
So there you can see what a successful packet session looks like. We're connected to AA4UT-10, which is the University of Tennessee Amateur Radios Club packet gateway here in Knoxville. They're actually on top of Neyland Stadium, which is a terrific location for an antenna. But anyway, this is what a successful one looks like. I highly recommend you try your internal TNC in your TS2000. I use mine all of the time. It's very successful. I haven't had a failure in a very long time. I just downloaded all of the three PacTor, Packet, and Winmore station lists from Winlink. One of those files was in excess of 32,000. No problem at all. Just cranked it right on through. So hope you try yours out and get a chance to use it. I've been real pleased with mine. With the correct settings, it works great. So that's it from K4REF.